Hello and welcome to California University Smart Classroom Training Series. My name is CJ DeJoyous. I'm the Instructional Technology Manager here in the Teaching and Learning Center. In today's tutorial, we are going to be discussing the Level 2 Intermediate Smart Classrooms here on campus. Those rooms consist of Duda 103, Duda 116, Eberly 110, Eberly 130, and Keystone 205 and Keystone 211. Within those rooms, there are three different operational modes. The first operational mode will allow you to control the lighting and the microphones outside of using any multimedia equipment by simply clicking on the items located here. You can adjust the microphones and be able to deliver audio. So if you're just lecturing and you have no need for utilizing the multimedia equipment, or if you'd like to adjust the lighting, if your students are taking a test, or if you are doing some other type of exercise where the lighting needs to be at a different level. There are four presets available. If one of those presets do not meet your needs, you can simply go over to the wall panel and turn all the lights on, which one of these buttons will also turn all the lights on in the room. But there are several other presets available on the touch panel located near the entrance of the room. I'm going to simply close that. Also within the microphones, you can adjust here if necessary. You can simply mute if you are not using any of the microphones, or if you would like to use the lectern mic, you can simply unmute the mic, adjust the volume up and down appropriately, and you should be good to go. The next two options that are available to you are System Start Presentation, and that's the one that we're going to be discussing within this tutorial. This particular mode is used when you are teaching locally within the room and you are not being linked to another classroom. The System Start Video Conferencing, which is referred to Link Classroom here on campus, is discussed in the other tutorials within this web page. If you are teaching in that fashion, you would want to refer to those tutorials. However, if you're not, you want to concentrate on this one. So, with that being said, let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to simply locate the Crestron touch panel, which is a 15-inch panel located at the instructor's lectern. When I do so, you will see the following menu that appears on the screen here. You will simply click the System Start Presentation option. When you do so, you will then see the following items appear on the screen. You have your destination options, and these are all the destinations where the multimedia devices can be delivered. You have your sources option. The sources are all the sources that are available to be delivered to your destinations within the room. You have your volume control, that you can control the volume for any selected source. And you also have the lighting control, very similar to what was shown earlier. You will see you have the four presets and you have the off, plus you can adjust manually using these items here to turn the lights up and down as you see fit. I'm going to jump back to my sources by selecting on the PC. Currently, my PC is being delivered to all destinations within the room, including the sound. There is an option to send sound separately if you would like to do so. For example, if you have an MP3 player that can connect to the audio connection that's available at the instructor's lectern near the VGA cable, those cables are used to connect mobile devices if they are compatible with that connection along with a laptop. So in your sources menu, you would select laptop and then select send to sound. And if your MP3 player is plugged in and playing properly, you should now hear that on the speakers within the room, and you'll still see your instructor's podium computer on all the monitors and projectors located within that room. In addition, if I would like to send my mobile device or laptop to the monitors and projectors, I simply would select them, and you can see they follow appropriately and also send the sound automatically. Same thing with the document camera. If you'd like to utilize the document camera, you simply click on the document camera, and select the destination. You will see when selecting the left projector, the left rear monitor follows. And also when selecting the front right projector, the right rear monitor will follow, which these monitors are considered confidence monitors for you to be able to look at as a reference as you are delivering your content. As you notice here, it says none for send sound because the document camera does not deliver any audio source, so this is not necessary. The Blu-ray / DVD player is located at the instructor's lectern, which is shown in the videos below. You can simply review the video for operation of that, but if you would like to deliver that content within the room, simply select the Blu-ray player, click on left front projector and right front projector, and this will deliver to all the devices. As you can see, I can send multiple sources to the different projectors. So for example, if I want to show a Blu-ray on one and a PC on the other screens, I simply select PC, and I'm sending the PC to the right front projector and the Blu-ray is being sent to the left front projector. But your last selected source will always follow the audio. So for example, in this, I don't want my PC audio to deliver because I just have a PowerPoint that contains some information about the video that I want my students to glance at while they are watching the video in the room. So in order to get my sound to go from the Blu-ray player to the speakers within the room, I simply select Blu-ray and then click on the source and you will see that it follows. In addition, as we discussed a little bit earlier, you have the microphone controls. If you are going to use the microphones for voice lift within your local presentation / lecture, you simply would adjust appropriately here by using the mute and unmutes. The wireless mic handhelds are located in the instructor's lectern in a storage compartment along with the wireless mic lavaliers. The lectern microphone is located on top of the lectern, you will see, next to the Sympodium smart podium monitor. So if you would like to utilize that, simply mute the others, unmute this one, and adjust the volume appropriately. In addition, in the system power menu, you have the following options. You have projector off left, you have on, you have projector off right, and on. Typically, you do not need to utilize these for any reasons. They are available if necessary. However, below you have the screen down and screen up commands, which are very helpful within the classrooms. Whenever you select the screen up, you will see the screen will go up and the projector will video mute, which reveals the whiteboard that is typically located underneath the screen. You can go ahead and then utilize the whiteboard within the room, and then when you're ready to show the last selected source that you were showing before putting the screen up, you simply select screen down and the projector will do an instant on. You do not need to wait for it to warm up, and you will see the content delivered within your screen. You can also power the monitors in the back off if necessary. In most cases, this is another option that you will not really need to utilize. However, if you don't want the content to be displayed on those monitors, you would simply select the off options within this menu. Now I'm going to jump back to the source and discuss to you the picture mute and the auto image. The picture mute will picture mute the projector that you select. This will basically blank out the screen, so if you don't want the students to see the content that you're about to deliver prior to the classroom, you can simply picture mute. Then when you're ever ready to begin class, you simply uncheck the picture mute and the content will be revealed to the classroom. All items within these menus are indicated in red when they are selected. Also, the auto image option would utilize if for some reason the image does not appear to be working correctly on the destinations within the room, such as your projectors. So simply select the auto image. In most cases, you will not need to utilize this. The one time that you may be is if you are delivering a laptop and it has a resolution that may be different from the system, what the system is used to, and you would simply select the auto image and it should adjust appropriately. For all your sources, you can adjust the volume levels using this item here. And then you can also simply click the mute if you'd like to mute the volume for the actual source that is selected. So in this example that I had just shown you, we are adjusting the volume for the laptop because that is the source that is being delivered to the send sound option. Okay, I think that covers all the options that are available, so we're going to go back into the system power option and we're going to shut the complete system down. You'll locate the total system shutdown button as seen here. Simply click the total system shutdown. Then you have the option, just in case you do this by mistake, do you want to shut it down or no, I'd like to go back. You would, if you did get into this menu by mistake, simply select no, I want to go back, and it will resume to the last menu. But in this case, we do truly want to shut down the system, so I'm going to simply select yes, shut down. When you do so, you will see the following item appear on the panel, which takes you back to the main screen for the next person who would be instructing within this room. The projectors will need to cool down, which are indicated by these blue progress bars located above. You cannot select any of these options here when the projectors are cooling down. They must need to be fully cooled down prior to being able to start the system again. However, you can access the lighting controls and the microphone options while they are cooling down. This concludes the tutorial for today. Please feel free to contact the Teaching and Learning Center via email tlc@calu.edu or via phone at 724-938-4168. Thank you.